is that in reading even the short pieces and this book, your pieces in your book, there seems to always be like lessons and reflections of gratitude and hope that culminate to me in the character and the story doing like a healing or exploration of and providing like a presence of hope for a lifetime or for their life. I mean, it's just, even in the shortest of stories,
it's my little thing. Whatever that is.
It's really,
I can't help it. It's like,
it's great.
That's what I do.
Because everything comes back to something, which we will now, I want to do one more thing and then I want to take another offering so that we can just delve totally into this book.
Thank you.
Now, this wonderful book, I don't know, I feel like some of it must be a little autobiographical or biographical. And at what point in your journey did you connect with Dr. Moody? Because the author of his book is Life After Life, because he really explores that whole thing, which for some of us is really hard to grasp and whatever.
Right, right.
And some of it's like, some people might say it's a little woo-woo,
right.
Some of it's whatever. But, it all comes down to, obviously you got to meet him, you did some work, he was a messenger for you. And
right.
I think in the book, and what I found is interesting about, because I've done Greek theater and there's always messengers in
right.
every tragedy and there's many of them. So he was a messenger for you. How did that come about? You don't have to tell all the details of why, but what ignited that? And then how would you come up with this, like, I'm going to take his kind of theories and, put them in a cogent?
Well, it's a long thing that happened, but as quickly as I can tell you, is my partner, Russ Stratton, who we're partners in it. We have a company together, a film company, and he's also my sweetheart as well, as it turned out.
Mm-hmm.
He had known Dr. Moody, and so they had a relationship, and then Russ Stratton had introduced me to Raymond about a film project, and we were chatting with him a lot about this project.
A project of, for his type of stuff.
Absolutely separate, mm-hmm. that maybe will manifest one day. And I spent about a year on the phone with him, just talking to him, and
mm-hmm.
I just sort of fell in love with his voice.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, just couldn't get enough of Raymond Moody.
Nice accent,
oh
too.
Oh, my gosh. Anybody who desires to know something or has any information they want, he has all the time in the world for you because
Very
he's so
easy,
profound.
Like.
He's so profound. Mm-hmm. And so we really connected. I don't know why he sort of let me into his
Space.
Masterful connection, but he did. And so when Russ and I were having lunch with him, I think for the first time I met him, Russ knew him before at Omega Institute.
Uh-huh.
I think it was around 2008. We were shooting The Breeze, and then a few days or weeks later, Dr. Moody's wife called me and said, Raymond thinks that you need to come to Anniston, Alabama and spend some time with him because he wants to tell you about the Greek philosophers and he wants you to write a book about it. And I'm just like, you've got to be kidding. I have no aspirations to write a book. I don't know anything about the Greeks really other than mm-hmm. the very basics, and that would be putting it mildly. But she convinced me to come, and It's a bit much longer story than that, but he basically taught me his course,
mm-hmm.
and I was very resistant, which is an interesting thing, because I think sometimes, I don't know about you, but when I resist something, there might be something really juicy happening, but I'm shut down because
yeah.
I'm like, it's this huge, like I've got to write a book.
It's overwhelming. Whatever. Or
completely
it's
overwhelming. So I
and
found
it's where
this,
you gotta
got this
go,
big
though, right?
wall. Of I'm not doing this, but he keeps telling me all of this stuff. So the morning before I was going to take off, I woke up with this entire book in my head.
Wow.
Yeah, I mean, not everything she does, but the beginning, middle, and end, and turning it into a novel. And I pitched it to them being Dr. Moody and his wife, Cheryl, and they just, the three of us were just bound from mm-hmm.